Welcome back to Let Us Learn to Lead video series on free open source software designed by M. Srinivasan, Training Associate Mathematics, Kendra Vidyalaya Sangathan, Zonal Institute of Education and Training, Mumbai. Self-learning contents in video form on GeoGebra, Dynamic Mathematics software, is presented at this video series. To view the contents, kindly join Google Classroom by using the class code 73AUMBO. In this video, you will learn designing worksheet to construct congruent triangles using SSS criteria and verify the properties. For preparing this video lecture, I used Windows 10 operating system, licensed version, GeoGebra 5.0, a free open source software, and free open source screen recorder software. Let us start. Let me tell you what type of worksheets we are going to prepare. We are going to tell the children that congruent triangle, SSS congruence. We tell them that what is the meaning of it. Two triangles are congruent if the corresponding sides are equal in length and the corresponding angles are equal in measure. If the three sides of one triangle are equal to three sides of another triangle, the triangles are congruent. There is another way of explaining it. We will draw one triangle now, and with the same side, that is AB, BC and AC, we will draw one more triangle, and we will tell them the properties. Number one, the corresponding angles are equal and the corresponding sides are equal. Now they can drag it and they can check out whether the angles are same. Not only that, remember, they can move this and put it over this and tell how they overlap. Normally we will tell the congruent triangles overlap. Let us try to design this dynamic worksheet from scratch. For that, I have taken GeoGebra Classic 5 worksheet and I have selected geometry view, and in the options I have rounded off to 2 decimal places or 1 decimal place. Whatever you want, both are one at the same. In labeling, I have taken new points only. Now you can explain to the children what do you mean by congruence, SSS, congruent triangles, because we are having different criteria. We can explain them. This is SSS criteria. Okay, now we can explain them also. Two triangles are congruent if the sides of one triangle or first triangle or one triangle is same as the length of the sides of another triangle. Okay, anyway, I think you know the way how to explain it. Okay, I'm just leaving it to you. You can type it and you know how to make it into two lines also. I'm leaving it to you. Now let me draw one triangle now very carefully. Let me take this polygon. Now you can start from ABC like this or AB from the bottom also, whatever you want. Let me start with A, B and C and then come back to A. Okay. Now to make it the next triangle, I want to make use of the sides only. Therefore, I want to know what is the length of the sides. But remember, these length of the sides are variables here. They are not constants. Let us see what is the variable here. For that, right click, go to object property. You should have selected the segment, not the whole this one. Therefore, I will select the segment only. Select the segment. Segment is selected, object property, label, name and value. Okay. Similarly, simply touch it, again go back to show label and then name and value. Again touch it, go to this show label and then go for name and value. Well, I think it is corrected to 2 decimal place, whatever may be, whether it is corrected to 1 decimal place or 2 decimal place, whatever may be. Okay. Now, let us try to draw one more triangle over here. Let us try to draw one more triangle. For that, let me go for this option, that is segment with the given length. Segment with the given length. I will take it. Let me simply touch it. You want a segment of AB. What is the length here? It is C. Therefore, type C. Small c, not capital C. Small c. Now you got it now. Now highly interesting. When I move this, that also moves. Well, now I want to get the other sides of it. For that, I want to take this circle with the center and radius. Let me touch the D. It will ask immediately radius. I want to give the radius as the length of AC. What is the length of AC here? Small b. Just to give small b. You got it now. Once again, go to the same circle with center and radius. Again, touch at E. Now you give the radius as small a now. Again, okay. Both of them meet at a point now. You go to this point of intersection here and touch it. You got it now. Now you got all the three points now. Go for the polygon now. Go for the polygon now. Let us go to the polygon. Just touch it, then touch it, then touch it, and then touch it. You got the polygon now. Now come back outside now. Remove these two circles. Show the object. And remove this circle as show the object. Now this G also we don't want. That also you can remove it. Okay. Now when I move this, you see it is totally moving now. Now you should know that these two triangles are congruent. Therefore the angles are equal and the sides are equal. How to show it? For angles, go to this and then click this angles. Again click this angles. Now the angles are equal now. You see, when you move it, the angles are totally equal. Now you have to show that the sides are also equal. How to show it now? How to show it now? For that, you have to touch it. You have to touch it and then right click object property. Then show label, name and value. Again touch it. Go for it. Show that name and value. Okay, I think name and value. Then again touch it. Go for it. And then go for name and value. Okay, now let us see. Now you can tell the children that they can come and drag it and then check whether the angles are equal and the sides are also equal. They can pull it and put it one above the other. They can put it and then check whether they overlap also. They overlap. Now for now, you can make use of this ABC over here and tell them that the angles, the corresponding angles are equal. You can type it and you can show them that how the corresponding angles are equal. Once again, you can tell them that the corresponding sides are equal. That also you can make use of it. Okay, well, now the corresponding angles and corresponding sides are equal. This is congruent triangle making use of SSS criteria. One thing you should be little bit careful. You can move only one triangle. Suppose this triangle only you can move. You see, this only you can move. This you cannot move. Therefore, one triangle is the original one. If you want to show the original one, what you can do? You can go to the object property. You can go to the color. You can little bit change its color also. Tell that this is the original triangle and this is the congruent triangle to it. So that you should know that which to be moved. Na? That is why. Okay. Thank you, friends.